Yeah, so
it's about, that is the glass cannon, and his opponent, Eevee over here. Eevee is actually a little bit of a veteran, but he goes back to the Injustice 1 days.
And Eevee sporting with Harley Quinn. And Kitty Z going with the solid Aquaman.
Aquaman, such a good choice in Injustice 2, and I like all the changes with some of these characters. Even Aquaman, who was just an iron wall in there in Injustice 1, has his matchups that your characters can give him trouble, as KDZ flawlesses Eevee here to start us off. He did play Harley back in Injustice 1, but let's come back a little bit up because he wasn't back up.
Okay, okay. I can respect that.
Oh, KDZ. Play to win, ladies and gentlemen at home.
KDZ putting on a clinic right now. Just bullying Harley, keeping her in the corner. Not much Emperor Eevee is doing, except just taking this trident over and over again. Here we go, getting on the board. Hyenas are out, KDZ blocks it.
Aquaman, not fair at all. Using weapons in a game like this after Savage and the wake up.
Emperor Eevee does have full bar right now. KDZ's probably gonna try to avoid the class situation. Probably going to confirm into some kind of bounce or go into tentacle strike meter burn.
Fantastic block. And if you're KDZ, he's punished that now twice with down one. If he wants to max damage it, you know you're going to punish it. Down one, he's from the deep. Massive damage. Oh, here comes a hyena. And how KDZ made it through that was ridiculous. There was a hyena coming to chomp at his feet.
The cupcake coming right at him.
And there was an air shot coming. And he just jumped on him. He can see us. Did you see that wink? He knew.
He knows. He knows. All the veterans are very good with playing with the camera when it's on them. They can see it in the corner of their eye.
Giving us a little bit of a show here.
Great trade by KDZ.
Okay, so he went for it there. He went for the punish, missed it a little bit, but there he was going for that down one DX from the deep. That is max damage punish from Aquaman with a six frame button.
KDZ opting not to go for the bounce or for the transition, keeping Harley Quinn in the corner. However, she does have an interactable at her disposal to get her out of the corner and into the middle of the stage.
And back one, two, three, so strong from Aquaman. Plus two on block, and it is his only plus string that doesn't have a gap in it. One, one, two, three has a gap, even though it's plus five, I believe. And four, one, two, three, which is at plus seven, I believe, has two gaps in it. So it's always good to throw back one, two, three. There's almost no reason.
Back one, two, three, yeah, it's very, very solid string.
They did take away the Phantom hitbox on the two and back one, two, so it can no longer anti-cross up.
Yes, 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 I remember
that. Good thing
that.
There, good thing there.
That was pretty bad. But they did fix the hitbox on the back two. Remember how bad the hitbox on the back two was?
Yes.
It wouldn't anti-air anything.
But there are still ways for Aquaman to gain plus frames in mix without gaps. His stand three is also plus. I mean, and his EX water shield also plus. He's got a lot of plus frames. They gave Aquaman a lot of plus frames. And you see here KDZ just running away with it right now. He has also a lot of plus frames on hit. That's why everyone loves Trident Rush now.
Plus frames on EX,
EX. He'll always have the bar. So you're either going to be minus five or plus enough to almost guarantee a back one check mid-screen. And in the corner, it's open season, baby. And Eevee here going with one of those characters that can give out some trouble in this game. As you saw earlier with Forever King and Dab.
Oh, man, that was incredible. Forever King up against the ropes and making this miraculous comeback against one of the best players in the NorCal scene.
And oh, look at the shimmy between these two. KDC does not want to do a from the deep. And he's keeping that simple. I like that he's doing that jump to combo. It still does an insane amount of damage, but he's not risking the back three whiffing. Because in most cases, you have to walk forward and then back three.
Yeah, and I think he also didn't want the transition. He wanted to keep the corner situation. He wanted to just,
ooh!
But unfortunately, Black Adam does just jump out of there. Are we gonna go scoop throw? He tried to go for it to put him back towards the corner. Fortunately, he dropped the throw part, or the forward two part.
And this is the mix that you saw exactly from Dab. When they're respecting the plus two, you just keep the train rolling, baby. Ooh, that was a big whiff from Eevee. Oh, and that's an easy hicker burn on a trident. Once you see the first couple stabs hit, you meter burn, you mash that board. Ah!
Okay. He did stop screaming.
He did stop screaming. That, you know what? And I'm
did
not
you just realize that right now?
No, someone actually told me that today, but I did not know that until someone told me today. And you know what? I'm not too sure. I really liked it.
I heard a little grunt, or was that Black Adam just getting hit?
That
might
have been Black Adam getting stabbed 40,000 times from veterans here. But you know what? The crowd always got into the Trident Rush.
Oh, yeah.
Everyone in the crowd. Oh! Oh, what a great...
Let's ask Ed Boon to patch it back in.
Sound guys, you can get Aquaman screaming for his life. In the 4-3!
Oh, KDC drops the combo.
Ungrabbable in the plus frames. And Eevee this time trying to disrespect it. Look like he tried to down one Palpatine Lightning Hands, and just the Lightning Hands came out. KDC taking his 3-0, looking clean.
Very, very solid play. Really nothing... really not lacking in anything, any department. Had solid defense, had a solid offense.